Hello, my name is Ugochukwu Ukwuemu. I'm a cloud engineer. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to install phpMyAdmin on an Amazon EC2 instance. This video is the fourth and final in a four-part tutorial series where I showed how to deploy dynamic applications to the AWS cloud. If you've been following us by this time, you should know what it takes to deploy dynamic applications, backends web applications, backends for mobile applications, and pretty much anything you can build using the LAMP stack to the AWS cloud. Let me begin with my presentation. As always, we begin in the console home of our AWS account, and the service we've been using is Elastic Compute Cloud. So we click on the instances service, and then that's the server we've been working with. In tutorial one, we set up this server and installed Linux, Apache, MySQL, and PHP on it. In tutorial two, we deployed a website on that server and tested it. In tutorial three, we deployed a WordPress application and tested it. From tutorial one to through tutorial three, we're working with the MariaDB database from the MySQL client in the command prompt. But now we'll be interacting with that database using phpMyAdmin, which is a web client. Of course, that's at the end of this tutorial. Okay, so we want to connect to our EC2 instance. As always, we locate where our key pair is. We launch our SSH client there and drop that command. Okay, first of all, if you recall, we have our key pair in that directory. Without that key pair, we wouldn't be able to connect remotely to our EC2 instance, which we are hosting in Europe. So I enter that command. It asks me if I want to continue. I say yes, since I know that was a server that I set up. So we're in the server, right, in Stockholm. That's how you know where it is from there. So the first thing we want to do is we want to log into our MySQL client. Password is okay. Looks like I didn't enter the correct password. Okay, that's better. All right, so those are the databases we've been working with thus far. The first thing we want to do, of course, using commands that have pre-typed to save on time, is we want to create a dedicated user with which we'll be accessing a database from the phpMyAdmin client. So we create that user, we grant all privileges to that user. Well, grant all user privileges should be for the super admin. If there are going to be several people interacting on that database, you are going to create separate users and grant them the appropriate permissions they need to interact with that database or with the respective database they're working on. So next, we're going to exit the MySQL client and install the packages we need for our phpMyAdmin. Some of those packages I use a sudo and I paste those the command with the packages. Don't like I've always said, there'll be a blog coming along with this tutorial, which you're going to find below the link below. All the commands I'm going to use here, you find it in the blog. So feel free to go there, copy and paste. So I've installed those necessary packages. The next thing I want to do is I want to restart Apache. So I paste that command there. Start the server. Next thing I want to do is I want to restart. That's PHP FM. All right. So the next thing I want to do is go to Apache document root, and that's where we're going to install the latest PHP MyAdmin release. So back to our terminal, I go to CD. As Apache document root, you can see the WordPress files of the WordPress application we've been working with previously. Okay. So I installed that. You can see in red the PHP MyAdmin latest tabol. So the next thing I want to do is unpack that tabol containing the PHP MyAdmin installation files. So I copy that command. I go back to run that to my terminal, paste that command. So basically, what that command is going to do is it's going to first create that my dash unique dash php myadmin directory, and then it's going to unpack that php myadmin latest all languages tabol file into that directory. So if we do an that done, if we do an ls, and we see that my unique php myadmin directory there. So if we cd into that, and do an ls. Okay, something didn't happen well there. All right, let's go back. I think I did not I ought to have downloaded that. A sudo. This usually happens. Okay, this is better. So let me okay, now that directory exists, so all I'll be doing here is just unpacking that tabol in that directory. So I do an ls and I cd into that my unique, and I do an ls. Okay, so now we have the files of our PHP MyAdmin directory. So the mistake I made earlier was that I downloaded, or I did a wget to download those PHP MyAdmin commands without using the sudo, right? So then it just behaved like it downloaded, but it didn't really download anything. So let's go and configure that. Okay, so we'll come back and delete that tabol when we get back to that directory. First of all, I want to make some configuration changes in that. If we look at the files that come with that PHP MyAdmin, you see this config.sample.ink.php. So we're going to drop a command now that will pretty much make a copy of that file in config.ink.php, and we go into that place. There's a variable that we need to add. So I do a sudo nano config dot ink dot php, right? So you see that line there, Blowfish secrets. I already copied a random string. Which I'm going to paste there. Okay. As for this is needed for cookie-based authentication to encrypt the cookie. needs to be a 32 bytes long string of random bytes. Okay, so one thing, let me make that a little larger. One thing I want you to note is the authentication type. Servers using cookie type. So I want to make save. I want to save that. Save the changes I made. Control X, Y, and enter. So that done. Okay. So I want to get out of that directory. Okay, let me clear this. All right. So I want to get out of that. My dash unique.php admin. So I want to now delete that tabble file that came when we downloaded that latest release of phpMyAdmin. So I do a sudo and paste it. Basically, sudo means acting as a super user. All right, so if I do an ls, that's gone. So let's go and see, knowing that we installed our phpMyAdmin client in that directory, my-unique-phpMyAdmin. So if we go and go back to our AWS console, we want to grab the external public IP of that web server. So we go drop it and my-unique-phpMyAdmin. Okay, so we see our installation was successful and we'll log in with our credentials. All right, so that was fine. We've installed phpMyAdmin web client on our Amazon EC2 instance. And if you see, those are the databases we've been working with from tutorial one, where we set up this to-do list table and we put populated it with content and we tested with a page that retrieved those contents and displayed it on the over the internet. And then in tutorial three, we installed this WordPress application, which went into the database and installed the tables that it works with. So this gives you the insight into the backend of the WordPress applications you probably see over the internet, right? And over 40% of the websites in the world are WordPress-based. So that tells you how important this skill can be to you, right? So this is it. We've achieved the object of our final tutorial. For a brief recap, by now you should have the skills you need to deploy to AWS Cloud using the EC2. And of course, EC2 is just one of the many services AWS offers. And one of the objectives I had while preparing this tutorial is to give you, especially beginners, or if you're new to the cloud, an insight into what it takes to deploy to AWS Cloud. I know AWS Cloud is the leading cloud provider out there. So I finally, one thing I usually do is one thing that I want to encourage you all is to save on cost. Once you're done using a resource, in this instance, the EC2 instance is our resource, is a web server, right? While it's running, it's accruing cost. But I'm done, the tutorial is over, I've achieved my objective, now I stop the instance. Later I'm going to come back and pretty much terminate it, right? So I would encourage you to do the same, to save costs for yourself and for the businesses or employers you work with. It's going to make things easier for you, right? So we've come to the end of our four-part series of tutorials. If you like what I've been doing, if you like these tutorials, feel free to like and share. If you have questions, drop them in the comments section below and I will answer you. Once again, my name is Ugochukwu Okwebu and I wish you a happy cloud experience. Bye-bye.